Elaine is a first-time caller out of Alabama. Sweet home Alabama. Elaine, welcome to the show.
Well, thank you, Jesse. How are you this morning?
All this well. I really appreciate you calling.
Well, I'm calling because I would like to bring something to light, and I know that me and my family and our group of friends, we watch you every day. And a couple of days ago, I live in Huntsville, Alabama,
yes.
And 2 days ago, an illegal immigrant brutally raped a little 12-year-old girl here in Gunnersville, Alabama.
Amazing.
Which is just maybe 5 miles, 8 miles from my home. And he had already been deported twice and come back to the United States. And after he brutally raped this child 2 days ago, they found him in another little town, which is just a couple of miles up from Gunnersville, hiding in a closet. And I'm here to say, if you come to Alabama, people think that a lot of the immigration is going on at the border wall in California and all of that. But if you come to Alabama in this area, you feel like you have stepped into Ecuador, Mexico, or somewhere, because we have been totally taken over here.
Amazing.
Now, this little girl will suffer for the rest of her life.
Yep, yep.
And my hope is to get this word out that they can lock this man up, hopefully for the rest of his life, and send him back to his country. We have just been overtaken, and our children, this is just one of many stories that is going on here in Alabama. We have had kidnappings. We have had rapes of children, just murders and everything, and it's all going, I mean, it's just like we're covered up here in Alabama. We can't go shopping in any of the stores. We can't do anything. We feel like we're in a different country.
Yeah.
And my hope is to let the great white hope, wall built.
Yep. You know, Elaine,
you got to get this wall built. You got crazy Nancy Pelosi, and you got crazy Ortiz, and all these others, Kamala Harris, and all of them wanting, saying there's no problem, there's no problem. Well, if they think there's no problem, let them come to our city. Let them come to Alabama, because, you know, they may get away with that stuff in California, but when you're in Alabama, we've got the good old boy syndrome, and I guarantee you that if they was to be able to get to him before the police officer's done, they probably wouldn't have a problem.
I blame the Democratic Party. I blame the right-o Republicans. I blame the never-Trumpers. I also blame the voters who vote for the Democrats and the weak Republicans, because those people want these illegal aliens in our country, and they want them here for votes, for money, and for so-called power. And I can't figure out for the life of me, why do the voters keep voting in the Democrats and rhinos who are not there for the people, but there for themselves? Because they're willing to put our lives at risk in order to get the vote. And look how they're fighting against the great white hope. This president want to put the country, is putting the country first, and they're doing all that they can do to stop him. And watch how the voters still going to vote for the Democratic Party, the right-o Republicans, knowing that these people don't care about the American citizen. It's mind-blowing to me. And it's going to get worse before it get better, because these Democrats and right-os are living in gated communities. They have bodyguards. They have guns. And they and their families are well-protected, while this young girl that was raped, as you allegedly raped by this illegal alien, would keep on doing things like that. It's mind-blowing.
And it's mind-blowing to me as well, because I don't understand why, I'm like you, why are these voters still putting these crazy people in? I'm watching Bernie Sanders go out there with all this crazy rhetoric that he's got going on.
Yeah.
Well, what is he thinking? And he's an old man. Why does he care about college education? I heard him say on television the other day, he said, well, we want to pay for 10 years of all this money being wasted, we could give back to these universities, to these college kids. Well, they don't have a clue, because they're not being taught.
That's right.
Not being taught. They're being corrupted by these college professors. My daughter is in college, and she's being taught that there is no God, that we live in evolution, and you know, and all this kind of crap. They don't even teach Alabama history anymore in our schools. I homeschool my 11-year-old daughter because I don't want her a part of what they're teaching, because they're not teaching. They don't let her pray in school. They don't let her worship God the way she wants to, but they can bring, they'll let these illegals come in, and these people that's raised in these Democratic homes, and these Muslims come in, and they make them take a minute of silent prayer for these Muslims and different, you know, different people, but they don't give the Christian children a chance to pray.
What?
They say, oh, no, you can't wear that. You can't wear Jesus on your shirt. Well, my husband, we live life. We're Christians. It's God. He's the head of my husband. My husband's the head of this household, and I run the family. And that's the way God intended it, and that's the way it should be. And I say, if my child cannot pray in your school, then my taxes can't go to your school. My child is coming home where she can learn that it's okay to worship God. But with that being said, we've got too many crazies. Kamala Harris, we want her in running the White House, a pot smoker, and listens to all this rap music.
And abortion and everything. She's a nasty, evil woman. But let me ask, Elaine, why do you and others like you send your kids to those schools, like you said, your daughter's in college now, knowing that this is happening to them? Why sacrifice them to that kind of brainwashing?
Well, you know what, Jesse? My daughter is 39 years old.
Oh, okay.
She retired from the military.
Oh.
And after she got out of the military, she chose to go to college to be a psychologist. And do something with social services or whatever. And she was always raised Christian. But now she had fallen away. She said, well, I'm in, I think it's called a Gnostic or whatever. And I'm like, what is wrong with you? You know, that's not the way you were raised in the home. But it's because she gets into these colleges and they brainwash these people, whether young or old, older, and they tell them, hey, you come from a tadpole. And, you know, there is no such thing as God. And there is that. And I told her, I said, every day you wake up and you are allowed to wake up and take a breath in your body, you know that there is a God.
That's right.
Because if there wasn't, you wouldn't be here.
Well,
but she's coming back around now, and she was Democratic. Now she's Republican.
Oh,
and
good.
She supports Trump and
right on.
The Republican Party 100%. But I sit here every night and I watch these shows, Sean Hannity and different ones, and I just look in amazement at these kids. If you'll just look, when these Democratic or these radical left radicals are, you know, that's running for running for the presidency, there's all young people behind them that don't have a clue
because they've been brainwashed. They've been brainwashed, Elaine. That's why they're demoralizing these young people, and they intentionally did that to them. So when they do run for office to get power and bring in those godless ideas, these young people will support it because they don't have any clue about what is right. That's why we're working overtime here to wake them up with the truth so that we can change what's happening.
Well, the thing that I say is half of them doesn't go to class. For instance, we know what's going on with this scandal in Hollywood right now. The one girl admitted, well, I just go for the partying and you know, all of this stuff. I really don't go. I really don't learn. Okay, well, with that being said, instead of going to class, they'd rather stand out with a sign in front of the schools and protest anything. They're not doing time in class. They're spending their money, but they're protesting nothing.
Something
they don't even know anything about.
That's right. I really appreciate you calling, and I'm sorry to hear about the young girl. That's terrible. But we got to change the government. We got to, parents need to be responsible, fathers and mothers, for their children and not sacrifice them to the children of the lie. Elaine, call me again. I really appreciate you. And for this to be happening in Alabama, it's over, folks.